What is a supercar, anyhow? Usually it's a ride that costs more than $200,000, has lots of horsepower, and looks the part. But bring many a so-called supercar to a racetrack, and they simply don't measure up. McLaren does things differently. The 675 Longtail costs, yep, $400,000 and has 666 horsepower, but it lives and breathes at the racetrack. This thing kicks ass. I'm at Monticello Motor Club in upstate New York, and this is a place I know well, like really well. Ferrari well, Lamborghini well, race car well. I've driven almost everything here. There are a lot of supercars out these days. It's a lot of ways you can spend 100 grand, 200 grand, or in the case of what we're driving today, $400,000. Why would you do that? Because you want people to be impressed, because you want people to like you, because you want a really shiny object. Well, all those maybe make sense, but in the case of this 675, it's because you probably actually know how to drive. This is a surgeon's instrument. We hear that a lot, and usually it's total bullshit. In this case, not bullshit. This thing is for real. It's got supreme balance. It's got actual downforce, which means that you carry more speed through the corners. You don't need to rely on these great carbon ceramic brakes, although you certainly can. And it's got a 666 horsepower, which just screams me down these straightaways, but I could just carry more speed than I've ever been able to carry on this racetrack.
So Longtail's an old name in the McLaren heritage. The F1, our first road car, was successfully raced in a few forms. It won Le Mans 20 years ago. And the F1 Longtail was kind of the classic ultimate iteration of the car. And so when we were looking for a name for the new car, our sportiest, our most track-oriented model, Longtail came back, and it was a good fit with the history of the brand.
And really, so it's got this huge fin on the back, and when you brake, the fin goes like this and captures the wind. And it's one of the things that makes this car so magical. And so that's also, it looks a little different than the standard model, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And you called it, it works. It's not just show. And yeah, compared to the 650, it's actually 50% wider, and it goes across the whole rear deck of the car, which makes a massive
We got race
difference.
Cars rolling by us, which shows. So I passed that guy earlier today, yeah. And he's in a real race car.
Was he one of the three asking for an order bank?
Yeah, he actually was. Yeah, he actually was, as a matter of fact. And that's the thing is, out here at a place called, this is Monticello, it's a private club. Guys do exactly what we did today. They drive up their expensive cars, they drive them. Some of those cars I've had out here by really famous brands, and they don't hold up. This thing is like a pinnacle of engineering. You have to be kind of a driver's driver to get why it's so awesome, but dude, it was awesome. Now, this car wants you to be in control, but it will do exactly what you tell it to. Like, get in really close to this curb, brake really late here. Oh, yeah, get off the brake, back on the gas, all the way back over here, and oh, yeah, I wouldn't ask this for many cars or expect it to perform like most cars. This is $400,000 of speedy goodness. It's a mid-engine, so that means it's behind your head, and that it's got a great wail to it. I've actually got it left in automatic, the transmission, right now. I could be shaft shifting using these flappy paddles, but it's so good that I don't need to. And you know what? If the machine is smarter than me, well, fucking in hell with it. It's smarter than me. What am I gonna do? I'm driving better with it in automatic than I probably would be in manual mode. So this car is just, it's so giving. It's a sweetheart. It's so balanced. It's just, this car is made to really do things. Now, they're fairly inane things. They're things we maybe don't need to do per se, but if you're into it, it's like anything else. You want the best instrument you can possibly find. And in my actually experience right now, this is one of the best instruments I've driven in a long time, if not potentially ever. This is a driver's car. They care so much about getting these little things right, then in the end it creates something that's much better than you have any hope for it to really be. What's interesting is, this is sort of, there are more expensive cars, there's less expensive cars in the McLaren line. This might be the most magical spot if you got 400 grand.